Edmita.
Good morning. Good morning.
How are you, Praveen?
Fine.
Where you are staying now?
So currently at Sadipur. My brother has a resident in Sadipur, Patel Nagar. So I'm currently staying there.
So what your brother is doing? He's also preparing. Younger to you or elder to you?
The same is. Actually graduated in the same year.
But who is elder? Are you twins?
No. So we are it's not a 6 months gap. I think I am elder.
I think.
Sir, actually what happens that when they make certificate, then he is basically my cousin brother.
So you say like this.
So they basically change the years. So on that basis, I am elder.
So you say it's not your real brother.
Yes,
brother.
Sir. Obviously, he is not my real cousin brother.
You are working in railway service, engineering service.
Yes, sir.
When did you join?
Sir, actually I cleared the exam in 2018. But I took 1 year extended ordinary leave. So I joined on 12 October 2020.
You have seen the form which you have filled? Till 31-8-2054.
Yes. You have seen or you have not seen that?
Yes, sir, I have seen that.
You have seen that means you have filled it deliberately or what?
Okay. You'll be 60 then, you know?
Yes, sir. That's right. Yes, sir, that's right. So it's written from?
Two means
till
date.
Continuing.
Okay, yes, sir. Yes, sir, yes, sir.
Nobody knows what will happen tomorrow.
Yes, sir, certainly, sir. Okay. Actually, I thought I have to give the exact date.
Tell me, if you are appointed secretary in your home state, Bihar,
yes, sir.
Which post you like to hold? Industries, health or social welfare?
And why? Sir, in social welfare, what will be included? Social security, will it include education also, sir?
No. Social security, taking care of weaker sections of society, SC, ST. OBCs.
Yes, sir. I will like to take a social welfare department, sir.
Why?
Sir, I think, sir, the inequality in society is too much, and the main problem is not only that we have to, someone else have to empower those people. First, they have to change themselves psychologically. So, sir, I want to talk to my main motive in IS is also to talk to people, listen to them and find solution by encouraging themselves that how they can find the solution. So that's why, sir, by being in the social welfare department, I can talk to SC people, ST people, as well as gender, find out what kind of problem they are facing, and based on that I will design the solution.
But for doing that, there's a lot of staff available. What working
I
at the ground level?
The
you will not be
process.
Working at the ground. No. You have become secretary, I'm telling you.
Sir,
not you have to go through the entire process. When you go through the entire process, you may not be working in that social sector. You may be working somewhere else.
But still, sir, I would like to go on the ground to talk to people. Then only better solution can be arranged.
Don't you think health also is a sector which is not working well at all in Bihar?
Yes, sir.
Health issues are there, but people are not getting any attention.
No doctors.
Yes, sir, certainly there is also a problem. But sir, my choice would be social welfare. But yes, healthcare is also equally demanding.
Okay. You stayed in the village anytime?
Yes, sir. In my house, that was sort of
village.
Village. Yes, sir.
Just tell me, 2-3 constitutional institutions and post at the central government level, state level, and constitutional institutions.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And post.
Yes, sir.
Tell me two things.
In general, from sir, for example, in the central government, there is Election Commission of India. UPSC, National Commission for SCs and STs.
And post?
Sir, post, sir, Chief Election Commissioner in UPSC, again they are chairman. And sir, in National Commission for SCs, again there is a chairman.
Then Mr. President are not constitutional boards.
Yes, those are also constitutional boards, sir. Sir, state level, sir, in political CM post, in High Court, sir, the Chief Justice of High Court, then state
below that?
Sir, in the village level, there is Panchayati Raj institutions. They were chairperson in the
This national monetization pipeline, you know.
Yes, sir.
Something has been started for that. Some initiative has already been taken by the government for leasing out for monetization.
Sir, in the railway, sir, a parliamentary committee went out to various places to look out for what kind of assets that can be monetized. So, sir,
after this announcement?
Yes, sir. Actually, I was doing training in Lucknow. So, parliamentary
committee.
Yes, sir.
Then, when it
sir, actually, next day they were coming. So that's why officers, they were very busy on that time of the day. So.
But any other sector has been started?
Sir, currently I have just heard about this vision document. Exact steps, sir, I'm not aware.
Okay. You are a civil engineer. Have you heard of transplantation technique of trees? Transplantation of trees?
Sir.
You
would have read in the papers also that big trees are being transplanted.
No, sir. I've not read about any space.
Any idea how those big trees can be generally planted, small seedling?
Yes, sir. I think, sir, to transfer such a big tree, we have to ensure that the entire root system needs to be transferred to sustain that big tree. So, sir, for that, we have to first excavate the area carefully and then...
Praveen, now.
Yes, sir.
UP has come up with a population policy despite of having a lower, TFR than Bihar. Don't you think Bihar should be coming up with a...
Sir, the way Bihar government is approaching the problem, they are focusing on women empowerment through education,
but,
employment.
It is a much slower process than having a strict rule-based process.
But I think that is... something where people themselves understand what is the importance of reproduction and how we can take care of the family, but where we suppress or we try to enforce something and without giving them proper education and health care, that solution I don't think is very sustainable.
What is your take on the Uniform Civil Code?
Sir, Uniform Civil Code I think is a nice idea because various fundamental rights are violated in personal code, personal
law.
Like
you said, for population policy, you said you can't impose on personal.
I am coming on that, sir. But sir, main point is again we have to respect the diversity of the law, custom. For example, there are many tribal people, many religious diversity. So in that case, sir, I think we need to look at the adverse customs and laws in each personal laws and try to remove them so that fundamental rights are not violated. Besides that, sir, I don't think we need Uniform Civil Code in such a diverse country.
Okay. I see an anomaly. The steel and cement price has increased substantially during the lockdown despite of having a shorter or lesser demand for these products. What has happened?
Sir, I think I can think of two reasons. First, supply chain was disrupted. It was very difficult to supply. So second thing, sir, even in international arena, China has stopped the, China has significantly reduced the production of steel. So sir, this too might be the reason.
You have been working as a, Indian Railway Service.
Yes,
from what time? Have you started working or are you still?
No, sir, I'm currently undergoing training.
You're currently undergoing
yes,
training.
Sir.
So, what role are you expected to play once your training is completed?
Sir, I will be posted in subdivision where I have to basically manage a track of around 150 to 200 kilometer, where I have to ensure inspection. After inspection, if there is any requirement of maintenance, besides maintenance, we need to take some new initiatives also. Besides that, sir, we have to ensure the welfare of the people working under me.
So, sir, as a part of the national monetization pipeline, railway is also a major part of this.
Yes, sir.
Can you tell me what is expected out of railway in the NMP?
Sir, as per the initial idea, sir, various stations are being monetized. For example, stations are being
developed. What is the target of monetization from railway? How much money is expected to be raised from railway?
No, sir, I'm not exactly aware about the exact data.
You talked about safety in those 200 tracks. What are the technologies which we are using to check these?
Sir, in railways?
In railways.
Sir, in the engineering department, one of the major cause of accidents are railway crossings. So, we are entirely removing the railway crossings. We are either constructing underbridge or overbridge. So, besides that, there is a problem of lack of maintenance in the railway track. So, for that, sir, we are drastically shifting to the mechanized maintenance of track that can easily measure the various parameters, and on that, actions can be taken. Sir, another problem is in the operation department as well as signaling department. Mainly during winter times, it's very difficult to see the signals. So for that, we are developing automatic fog pilot assistance system, which can give the what kind of signal is coming right here in the cabin locomotives.
So what kind of changes has happened in the track laying technology? As in, are we still following the colonial practices in terms of track laying?
No, sir. We are increasingly using machines. For example, there's a PQRS machine that can lay the entire sleepers. And there's a machine that is called T28 that can lay the entire crossing of the rail track. So these kind of machines.
What will be the impact of introduction of Indian Railway Management Service on your engineering service?
Sir, in the initial phase, we will be given the role of what we are going to do, that is engineering. So on that basis, first time we will do engineering only. But side by side, people are saying that our promotion will increase if it is IRMS service, because other department gets promotion faster than engineering department. So besides that, we will be able to gain the knowledge of other department also if we are allowed to work in other different departments.
Despite of such a promising career and improved promotion opportunities, you have opted for every service in civil services.
Yes, sir.
Even for Group B services. Will you be opting for these as well?
Sir, actually, once I get posted in engineering service, I won't be able to give the exam. Not because there is a constraint, but the responsibility is quite large. So, sir, if I get any service, then I can leave railway and keep continuing the preparation for
civil services. So, you'll leave railway even if you get a Group B service?
Sir, because I think, sir, this is the only way I can continue the preparation for civil service.
So, do you think what you are doing in railway service is not as important as what you would do as a part of civil service?
No, sir. I think railway is a great service. I have a lot of opportunity, but I think my interest lies where I can talk to people and go in the field, such kind of work.
You feel posting even in administrative services only for a short duration. Rest of the time you would be desk-bound. In other services also, it will not be much interaction if you take most of the other services. So what do you think?
Sir, I don't know what kind of challenges and other problems will come, but I think even on those times, I will try to go in the field and talk to people.
And last set of questions. You play squash.
Yes, sir.
The squash ball has different color dots
yes,
on
sir.
It. Can you tell me what are the different colors and what does it mean?
Sir, basically there is one dot and double dot. So one dot has more bouncing. So that is mostly
also yellow, red.
Yes, yellow, red also, but I don't know the significance of color basis, but I know dot wise. So sir, one dot has more bounce. So that is mostly played by initial players, but double dot has less bounce, which increases the reach of the player, and that is mostly played in the tournament and by mature players.
Why is Pakistan performing significantly better than India in squash?
Yes, sir. Right from the times of 1980s, there have been good players
for Pakistan. Why do you think we are not able to perform as well as Pakistan?
Sir, I'm not exactly aware that what kind of condition existed.
Squash is not very popular in India. You were in IIT, that's why you could perhaps
yes, sir.
Play.
Yes,
sir. I don't see squash.
Yes, sir.
In most places you don't have, even in clubs and all.
Yes, sir.
But is it faster than tennis? Is it more exhausting?
Sir, yes, sir. As per other people's experience, because if basically in railway training, there were people who were playing both games and they were saying that it's more exhausting because the decision and agility is to take decision, we have to just wait for some nanosecond, millisecond, sir, while in tennis there is more time for acting. So that's why, sir, it's more exhausting in squash.
Okay, now what do you think of the lateral entry? Now, government is allowing people to come on grand entry.
Yes, sir.
So what do you think of that?
Now we
welcome that?
Yes, sir. We need a diverse set of people, especially the kind of technology that is coming. We need people from research background, academy background, as well as private sector also, that can increase the policy making at the higher level. But sir, there are some caveats also, that we need to ensure that they remain in the service for some period of time.
No, that will be taken care of, but then your movement will be restricted, no? From promotion to the age level and all that, people from outside are going to come. Don't you think so?
Sir, certainly there will be impact on promotion, but sir, I think the kind of job and job diversity that IAS provides is very immature to limit it only on the basis of promotion. We can do a lot of work in IAS.
Sir, you are now in Lucknow undergoing training?
Sir, yes, sir.
Where? In RDSO?
No, sir. It's the construction, basically, Northeastern Railway Construction Department.
Okay. How about RDSO? Have you visited?
Sir, actually, I have been in Lucknow because my Mausi lives in Lucknow. So I have been to, because in that campus my Mausi lives, so I have been to RDSO, but as a formal training, I have not been to RDSO.
Do you know what exactly they do?
Yes, sir.
What is the full form of RDSO?
Sir, it's Research, Design and Standards Organization.
Standard.
So, yes, sir.
Now recently they come out with some device for signaling. Are you aware of that?
Yes, sir. Sir, there is automatic train protection system, again fog pilot assistance system, then automatic train collision avoidance system. So such kind of technology they are coming with, sir.
So regular interval, you have to fix that device, no?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. RFID tag.
I was a bit surprised. The civil engineer will be keeping track of conditions of the track. Basically, that's what you said.
Yes, sir.
So there should be much more than that. Is that the only job?
No, sir. This is the main which we have to take care in permanent way. But other than that, sir, various station buildings or other official buildings or as well as colony maintenance, such kind of work will also be taken care of.
But otherwise, now railway stations will also be privatized, isn't it? What exactly will be done under this?
Sir, for example, in a railway station, a private company can run the entire management of that thing. But again, sir, in that case also, a railway officer need to supervise those things, that whether they are doing proper job or not.
So, more of supervision than anything. Okay, now we have done IIT Kanpur Civil Engineering.
Yes, sir.
Tell me, you are familiar with Delhi, I'm sure.
IIT Delhi, sir.
But now about Delhi Metro, you have traveled extensively.
Yes, sir, certainly.
Now, number of tunneling they have done.
Yes.
How exactly they do? There was a special machine they used. Are you aware of that?
Yes, sir. It's tunnel boring machine.
Mm.
So basically, from where? I mean, where?
It was imported.
Okay.
Germany.
Yes, sir. Germany, sir.
What exactly was the thing?
Sir, tunnel boring machine.
Mm.
So basically, sir, tunnel boring machine has a cutter. So through and there is a clamping system. So basically, it gets thrust from the clamping system, and through that cutter head, it cuts the rock. And there is an conveyor system that can remove all the dust outside. So this is the way.
How that area they could do that?
Yes, sir. So what they do, sir? First, they construct a diaphragm wall so that a large area for a station can be constructed. And from that place, they lower the tunnel boring machine, and then they can go. And do tunneling.
Now, because of metro, we are getting carbon credits. How,
yes,
come, how do we get carbon credit because of metro?
Sir, basically, there are two ways. First is regenerative braking. Through that, they generate electricity. Besides, they are continuously shifting to renewable energy. And there is one more thing, sir. DMRC is also calculating how much shift has been from road areas to metro. And through that, they have basically filed for carbon credit.
Okay, now we have driverless engines in metro.
Yes, sir.
How exactly it operates?
Sir, again, they have automatic warning system. There's basically entire signaling system remains in the computer. And based on that, they can operate from a centralized operating system.
Okay, final question. Something on 15th Finance Commission. You are aware of the recommendations?
Yes, sir.
One, two, three, four, five.
Sir, first thing, sir, 41% has been devolved to states and 1% to UTs of. And so, besides that, they have recommended for disaster mitigation fund. And.
Any percentage? Okay, go
on. No, sir. Percentage has not been said. And there has been a recommendation for defense-related funds, sir. That there should be a proper fund for defense.
How about population? Which year did they consider?
Okay, sir. Sir, for distributing 41% of the amount, they have considered 2011 population, but they have, for incentivization of population control, they have given around, I think, so not exactly aware about the percentage, but they have given some weightage to 1971 population also.
Which states are likely to benefit because of this?
Sir, because of incentivization to population control, mainly southern states are going to benefit.
Mm-hmm. Anything on forestry? Have
yes, sir. They have given weightage to forestry also.
How much?
Sir, not exactly.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
How do you make a building earthquake resistant? And I think you have done some work also for that.
Yes, sir. Sir, first thing, sir, the material that should be used, the steel should be highly used because very ductile. So it will prolong the failure. Second thing, sir, the shear wall should be constructed. So third thing, there should be symmetry in the structure. So fourth thing, the foundation and the building, it should be separated by some sort of flexible foundation where can be the movement of foundation can be separated from the building. So fourth thing, seismic dampers are also being used to basically absorb the energy of earthquake. So
you're talking about the third point, the rollers.
Yes, sir. Rollers that is placed between foundation and the building. So
is
that
it practical? Is India now buildings are being constructed in earthquake prone zones using that?
No, sir. I'm not aware that any building has incorporated this technology.
What is Charpak scholarship?
Sir, Charpak scholarship is basically funded by the French embassy, which was named after Dr. George Charpak, who was a Nobel Prize winner in physics. So basically, they provide a scholarship for 30 students to do research internship in France for 3 months.
You went there?
Yes, sir.
What was the research topic?
So it was based on a landslide. So basically, a large landslide had occurred in the Annapurna area of Nepal. So we have to do research regarding whether this was gravity-induced landslide. Because if it is, then there's a possibility that it may happen again and there can be a large catastrophe.
What are the factors lead to landslides?
Sir, if we categorize, they can be natural and anthropogenic. So in natural, if there is a large precipitation or there can be earthquake, so based on that, landslide can happen. On man-made, sir, if we are doing a lot of deforestation, we are constructing roads, we are constructing various hydropower stations. So, sir, this can be the factor. And further, sir, climate change is further excavating.
And how? What are the civil engineering solutions for it?
Sir, every area has different solution. For example, civil engineering solutions, sir, we construct retaining walls, we basically do rock bolting, we basically use various kind of geosynthetic materials. But sir, natural solution is more better place to ensure sustainability of such.
Recently, Habibganj railway station was there in news.
Yes, sir.
Why? Can you tell me the reason?
Sir, I'm not sure, but I think because of station development, redevelopment, sir.
Yeah, and it's also a green building?
No, sir, I have not read about this, sir.
How to make the building more sustainable?
Sir, right from the construction of building to its disposal, we have to think in green terms. So, sir, for example, during construction, we can use all the local materials, all the materials which can be reused, for example, construction waste, those can be used. So besides that, sir, during the operation of that building, how its energy consumption can be reduced, basically energy efficiency. So for example, sir, you should provide good ventilation. Sir, smart housing can be adopted. For example, if there is no people on the home, in the home, then light and fan can be automatically stopped. So such kind of.
Okay. Why is Bihar still lacking in development? Why new industries are not coming up in Bihar?
Sir, in Bihar, first thing is there is a lack of infrastructure. For example, power, road, buildings, such kind of thing. The second thing, low human resource capital formation, sir. We have not invested not properly in health, education and nutrition. The third thing, as Bihar is landlocked, and it has less mineral also. So that's why industry has not been set up. So these are the current reasons. But sir, it has become a problem because of history also. Sir, right from the times of independence, before the independence as well as after independence, there has been government policy which has sort of discriminated against Bihar. So that's why.
Floods is a common occurrence, yes, in Bihar.
Sir. So in northern Bihar, sir, flood is one of the main reason for poverty, sir.
Okay. Floods are recurring in Bihar, right?
Yes, sir.
What are the civil engineering solutions for it? And why Bihar, what Bihar government is doing to resolve this issue?
Sir, Bihar government is mainly focusing on, sir, two approach, structural and non-structural approach. In structure, sir, they are constructing embankments. They are training the river so that it can flow in limited areas. Besides, sir, all the silts that gets deposited in the river, those are also being removed. Sir, in non-structural approach, we are basically trying to remove people and basically habitation from the floodplain areas. Besides, sir, the flood forecasting system is being improved. So, sir, these are the main solutions.
You have filled IFS, sir, last question. You have filled IFS at the 7th option, right?
Yes, sir.
Why so?
Sir, actually, I don't want to go to foreign areas for service. I want to remain in India, that's why, sir. And if I get
any particular reasons? Any particular reason for
it? Sir, I can relate more to the basically people of India, village areas of India.
That's also serving India, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
April,
yes, sir.
You will do is what?